And I can't stress how important it is that we do honor and remember those we've lost and the families they've left behind. I was at an event back in January and speaking to a crowd about something that had nothing to do with military service. But I knew that one of the folks who'd been part of this organization had actually been a member of our armed services and had in fact died in Iraq. So in the course of my comments, I just spent a few minutes talking about him. Talking about where he was from, what he was interested in as a kid, why he joined the service, how he died, and how much he would have loved to have been there that day to continue to participate in this community service activity with all of his friends and his colleagues. And I ask for people to just take a moment of silence to remember him. People did that. It was beautiful. And then a few months later, a letter showed up at my house that had gotten lost in the mail at the State House. And it was a letter from his mom. And she said, "I just wanted you to know that even though I wasn't there that day, a whole bunch of people reached out to me and told me what you said about my son. And I just want you to know how important it is to us, the parents, the families of those who are lost, that they not be forgotten, that they be remembered, and that people continue to speak of them and speak well of them now that they're no longer here to continue to create their own memories." It's a beautiful letter, but it spoke to this notion that's so important and so powerful that we, those who benefit from the service and the sacrifice of those who wear the uniform and their families, need to be clear about our commitment to honor them, to remember them, and to thank them for what they have done on our